यस स्क्रीन इज विजिबल, स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू ऑल। ओके
सर।
फाइन। सी एंड आई वांट द सेशंस टू बी इंटरएक्टिव। सी इफ एनीबडी इज नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एनीथिंग, एज यू ऑलरेडी नो, ए डिविजन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी नोइंग रिगार्डिंग इट। इफ यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एनीथिंग राइट, यू टेल मी, रिपीट इट वंस अगेन सो दैट आई कैन रिपीट द थिंग्स वंस अगेन। इफ यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन बिटवीन राइट, यू कैन इंटर इन बिटवीन, यू कैन इंटर यू कैन टॉक एंड यू कैन टेल दैट इफ एनीथिंग इज नॉट बीइंग अंडरस्टूड। ओके सो विल राइट, विल गो अहेड राइट विद द थिंग्स दैट वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन योर टैक्योमीटर राइट। In your module 2, we will be seeing first the syllabus, right? And then we will be seeing what we are going to learn. Okay, so we have finished already regarding module 1. We have seen what is theodolite, what are its type, fundamental axis, and the parts of transit theodolite, uses, temporary adjustments, permanent adjustments, measurement of horizontal and vertical angles, step-by-step procedure for obtaining the permanent adjustments of transit theodolite, and we have already discussed regarding the trigonometric leveling, how the heights and distance. Right, how the heights and distances are going to be measured by using the single plane and the double plane method. Now we will be studying regarding right the tachyometry. Right, here we are going to concentrate regarding the tachyometry. So now in this particular module, we will be seeing what is tachyometry, why we call it as an tachyometer or a tachyometry, right? And then we are going to see what are the basic principles are involved in the tachometric surveying, right? Different types of tachyometry, then distance, right? For measuring distance, right? How we are going to measure, right? If the conditions are having the horizontal line of sight and the inclined line of sight, here basically we are going to concentrate our study on the fixed hair method. Okay, we are not going to concentrate our study on other different methods, right? We will be concentrating our study on only the fixed hair method, that too, right? That too, with having the horizontal line of sight and the inclined line of sight. Okay, now the geodetic surveying, after this, we will be studying regarding what is a geodetic surveying, right? What is geodetic surveying we are going to study in this? The principle and classification of triangulation system and selection of baseline stations and orders of triangulation figures, then reduction to center and selection and marking of stations, that we are going to see after the tachyometric survey is going to over, right? After tachyometry, we will be studying regarding all these. Okay, now as you people are together, right? I will be for B division students. I will be telling some of the very basics, right? Regarding your theodolite, because see here, I have mentioned horizontal line of sight and inclined line of sight. In order to understand, you need certain basics, or see, you needed to know how actually the theodolite is going to work. I will be explaining hardly for 5 minutes, and then you should, if you are getting it, then we will be moving with the tachyometric surveying. Okay, so we will see, right? We will see what is the theodolite. I think you have seen the theodolite. Yes, you have you seen the theodolite? Yes, theodolite has been seen by B division students. Yes, theodolite. Have you seen B division? बी डिवीजन, आई एम आस्किंग टू बी डिवीजन स्टूडेंट्स, हैव यू सीन थियोडोलाइट? प्लीज इंटरैक्ट, हैव यू सीन थियोडोलाइट? बी
यस सर,
डिवीजन,
यस
ओके.
सर,
सो ओके, फाइन फाइन. सो एंड प्लीज बी इंटरैक्टिव वेन एवर द सेशंस आर गोइंग ऑन. इफ यू से आई मे नॉट सी योर चैट बॉक्स व्हेन यू हियर यू आर गिविंग अ रिप्लाई, यस आई मे नॉट सी योर चैट बॉक्स, प्लीज रिप्लाई टू मी इन द वॉइस, बिकॉज आई विल नॉट बी लुकिंग टुवर्ड्स माई मोबाइल, राइट? आई एम कनेक्टिंग माई मोबाइल विद द कंप्यूटर एंड देन आई एम टीचिंग यू, सो आई मे नॉट सी द मोबाइल, सो यू रिप्लाई इन द वॉइस. ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज योर थियोडोलाइट, राइट? आर यू गेटिंग? दिस इज योर थियोडोलाइट. सी थियोडोलाइट, वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर द हॉरिजोंटल एंगल एंड द वर्टिकल एंगल. द हॉरिजोंटल एंगल विल बी मेजर्ड फ्रॉम द योर लोअर प्लेट, दैट इज योर द हॉरिजोंटल सर्कल, एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर द वर्टिकल एंगल्स, राइट? वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर द वर्टिकल एंगल बाय यूजिंग द वर्टिकल प्लेट और द वर्टिकल सर्कल. दिस इज वी कॉल इट एज एन हॉरिजोंटल प्लेट, दिस इज वी कॉल इट एज एन वर्टिकल वर्टिकल प्लेट. हॉरिजोंटल प्लेट वी विल बी यूजिंग टू मेजर द हॉरिजोंटल एंगल, एंड द वर्टिकल प्लेट वी विल बी मेजरिंग द वर्टिकल एंगल. दिस टेलीस्कोप, राइट, दिस टेलीस्कोप इज फिक्स्ड विथ दिस वर्टिकल सर्कल, राइट, और द वर्टिकल प्लेट. फ्रॉम हियर वी आर गोइंग टू मेजर द वर्टिकल एंगल. दिस एक्सिस इज वी कॉल इट एज एन ट्रुनियन एक्सिस. दिस वर्टिकल प्लेट इज अटैच्ड टू दिस हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस, एंड द हॉरिजॉन्टल सर्कल और द लोअर प्लेट इज गोइंग टू बी अटैच्ड टू द वर्टिकल सर्कल. दिस इज अटैच्ड टू द वर्टिकल सर्कल इज अटैच्ड टू द हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस और ट्रुनियन एक्सिस, एंड दिस लोअर प्लेट इज अटैच्ड टू द वर्टिकल सर्कल. हियर वी कॉल दिस थियोडोलाइट एज अ ट्रांजिट थियोडोलाइट. वी कॉल दिस एज एन ट्रांजिट थियोडोलाइट. दैट मीन्स वी कैन चेंज दिस वर्टिकल सर्कल फ्रॉम फेस लेफ्ट टू फेस राइट. How we are going to turn change by we are going to rotate this particular upper screw, right, and we can transit it. Okay, so as of now you can understand this much is we can measure the horizontal circle, horizontal angle by this lower plate, right, and this particular vertical angle we are going to measure, right, with this vertical plate, and in order to see the objects we are going to use this theodolite, and this theodolite can be moved, right? Just a minute, I will be telling you, right, how the theodolite can be moved, right? How the theodolite, because this is very, very important in order to understand the tachyometry. Suppose this is your staff, right? This is your staff. You are going to, right? And this is your theodolite, right? Now, in your dumpy level, what is going to happen? You cannot move this particular line of sight, right? In your dumpy level, you cannot move this line of sight, right? This line of sight, you cannot move it. Here, from the dumpy level, you are going to take the readings, right? Whatever the line is there over here, or whatever the line of sight, wherever it is going to have, we cannot change this line of sight. But if you are going to use, this is a dumpy level, okay? This is your dumpy level. And suppose now I am using the theodolite over here, right? Suppose this is your theodolite. I'll be using short form theodolite. Okay, this is your theodolite. Now, as I can measure the vertical angles, right? I can measure the vertical angle. What here from here by if you are this is your objective lens, this is your objective lens, and this is your eyepiece. Right. So if I want to look straight, right, I will be keeping my eye, your my object or eyepiece exactly horizontal. If I want to take the perfect horizontal angles, right, or perfectly, if it is properly your telescope, if it is properly center, or if I want to take the horizontal, perfect horizontal line, right, or the angle, right? The vertical angle zero, right? I can make this completely horizontal. Your telescope I will be making completely horizontal, and I will be taking the reading. But if I want to read the stop reading, suppose we'll take it as R, right? I cannot change the angle for the dumpy level, right? I'm telling you the basic difference between the dumpy level and the theodolite. Because in order to tell tachyometry, right, this is going to be very, very important if I want to tell you regarding tachyometry. Now, here in the dumpy level, I cannot move this vertical angle, or I cannot move this particular telescope, right? I cannot move this particular telescope from the required, from the present place. But here, in case of your theodolite, right, I can move the telescope, right? I can move the telescope as I wanted. As I wanted, I can move it. Okay. So this is your telescope. However, I can take the reading. So from here, zero, I have rotated it to say around 45 degrees. I have rotated it to 45 degrees. So even I can rotate it to 80 degrees, right? 80 degrees I can rotate. Even I can rotate it to 90 degrees. So I will be rotating, say, from 0 to 90. 0 to 90, I can rotate it. So here, this is the basic difference between your theodolite, and this is the basic difference between the theodolite and the dumpy level. Dumpy level, I can only take the horizontal line of sight, whereas your theodolite, I can take the horizontal line of sight also and the inclined line of sight. So this is going to be very, very important in order to understand your tachyometer. Okay, because you should know what is horizontal line of sight, what is inclined line of sight, because without knowing this, we cannot go ahead with the tachyometer and all. We cannot go ahead with it. Is it clear to you, B division students? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, others, except Rishabh, others, please
Yes, sir.
reply.
Yes,
Please
sir.
reply, or else I cannot go ahead. If you are not replying, I cannot understand whether you are understanding or no. Yes, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, fine. So I will be moving ahead directly with the tachyometer now, right? So this is what I was telling about, right? So this is your eyepiece and this is your objective lens. Now here, in order to study the tachyometer, this is going to very, very important, say, lens. Right, your object, your tachyometer, the lens is going to be important because it all depends on your lenses, right? Yeah, we can say it as an tachyometer, as an optic, your optical distance measurement, that is ODM, that we are going to do with the help of this particular lens. So lens is going to be important in case of your tachyometer. So here, what I was telling, see here. In your theodolite, as you can see, this is an in an inclined position, right? Your telescope is in an inclined position, so we can rotate this particular telescope, or we can move this particular telescope up and down, right? As we want, we can move it up and down. We can have the angle of depression also. We can have the angle of elevations also in this your theodolite. So again, how the operation and all it will be done on this, that will be explained to you later. But as of now, this particular telescope, it can be moved up and down, and we can take the vertical reading, and this we can take the horizontal reading, is very, very important, right? So vertical reading, if we want the height of a building and all, we will be taking the vertical angles. And if we want to know what is the angle between the two points on a plane, right, then we are going to measure this by the horizontal circle. Height of a building and all, we can measure it by the vertical circle, and the angle between the two points on a plane, we can measure it on a horizontal plate or horizontal circle. Okay, so we'll move ahead directly with your tachyometer now. We'll move with the tachyometer. Okay, now we will see what is exactly the tachyometric surveying is. We will look it into it. Okay, now tachyometry, right, or tachymetry or telemetry, right? It is a branch of angular surveying, right? in which we are going to measure the horizontal and the vertical distances of a points are obtained by optical means, right? By optical means, as opposed to the ordinary slower process of measurement of chain and tape, right? If you take, right, it is an, I'll repeat the definition once again. Tachyometry is a branch of angular surveying in which the horizontal and the vertical distances, right, of points are obtained by optical means, right, in opposition to the measurement of chain and tape. See, if we want to have the chain and tape kind of a surveying, if we want to measure the distances and all, right, how we used to do it, right? If we want to measure the distance between the two points, we used to have the chain and tape and we used to measure it. But by without using the chain and the tape, we can have this tachyometric surveying and we can have the angle between the two points, right? So angle between the two points or the height between the two points, right? The distance between the two points that it can be measured. Okay, so this is a rapid method of surveying, right? This method is very rapid and it is going to be convenient as we are not going to use the chain and the tape over here, right? We can measure the distance, right? The vertical and the horizontal distances, we can measure it in a very rapid way. Okay, and it is the best adapted in obstacles. This method is going to be used when, right? In case of the broken land, right, or in case of deep ravines, or in case of stretches of water, right, which make difficult the chaining, right, or wherever we cannot measure the distances in the difficult terrains, right, in the difficult terrains, wherever there is a difficulty in measuring the distances, there we can have this particular, right, the tachyometer or tachyometry. Wherever there are obstructions, we can use this particular tachyometer, right? The primary object of tachyometry is preparation of contour maps, right? Wherever we want the contour maps, plans, or both the horizontal and the vertical control, right? And also on surveys of higher accuracy, it provides a check, right? Or on distances measured with the tape. It is wherever we are going to have the, if we want to have the contour maps, right? If we want to have the horizontal and the vertical distances, right? With the higher accuracy, wherever the higher accuracy is required, there we can have this tachyometric surveying. Okay. Now, tachyometer, again, it is an Greek, right? Greek quick measures. It is a system of rapid surveying by which the position, both the horizontal and vertical points on Earth's surface can be relatively determined with another without using the chain or tape or a separate leveling instrument. Without using any kind of a chain, tape, we can measure the vertical distances, vertical and horizontal distances. Then we will see what are the different uses of this tachyometry, right? Now, tachyometric methods of surveying are used with the advantage over the direct methods of measurement of horizontal distances and differences in elevation, right? It is also having going to have, in addition to measure the horizontal and your vertical distances, we can measure, in addition to this, we can have the preparation of topographic maps, which require both the elevation and the horizontal distances. Wherever the sometimes what we need is we want the topographic maps. So in that particular case, wherever we want the topographic maps along with both the elevation and the horizontal distances, there we are going to use this particular tachyometry. Okay, then wherever we want to have a survey work in a difficult terrain, right, where the direct methods are inconvenient, as I have told you, wherever the difficult terrain is there, or wherever we cannot measure the distances, right? So there we can have this particular tachyometric survey. Now, and next is reconnaissance survey for highways and railways. This we can use it. Checking of already measured distances. If anybody has done any kind of a survey work, If we want to check the accuracy of that, right, in order to check that, again, we are going to use this tachymetric surveying. And if we want to have the hydrographic surveys, right, and then establishing the secondary control, right, so there, all these regions we can use you your we cannot use a normal our dumpy level, or we cannot use any other instrument, but we can use this tachymeter or tachymetric surveying. We can use it. Now, the instruments that we can use, right, for your having the your tachymetric surveying is, right, an ordinary, remember, we are going to use an ordinary transit theodolite, right, an ordinary transit theodolite fitted with the stadia diaphragm is generally used for this tachyometric surveying. Now, we are going to use the reason why I have told you regarding the bit regarding your theodolite is because we are going to do this tachyometric survey by using this theodolite only, right? We are going to use this theodolite, which is going to have the stadia diaphragm. Now, what is the stadia diaphragm that we are going to see it? Okay. Now, stadia diaphragm essentially consists of one stadia here above and other below, right, at the equal distances of horizontal crosshair. The stadia hairs being mounted in a ring and on the same vertical plane and in the as the horizontal and the vertical crosshair. So now, what is that upper stadia diaphragm and the lower stadia diaphragm? Now, this center one, right, we call it as a crosshair, right? The center, this is your lens, right? This is your lens. Whenever if you want to see an object, right, if you want to see an object, right, I will show you with your theodolite. Yes.
So people are asking to join the meeting.
Which meeting? Class?
Yes, sir.
They are late then. You are B division students?
Yes, sir.
Though after putting the message also, in just a minute, I'll allow them. After putting the message also, you people do late joinings. So this is the problem because I have waited for 12 till 12:35. No, they are not, there is no request to join the meeting. Who is speaking? Rushabh, you are speaking. Who was telling that?
Samir.
Irshad?
Yes, sir.
But there is no request.
They are texting, so I told so.
They tell them to have that link. No, they are having the link.
Yes, sir.
Then tell them to send the request once again.
Okay, sir.
Okay, now so where I was. Okay, so here we are going to have these particular stadia diaphragm. We are going to have the crosshairs, right? We are going to have the crosshairs on the lens. From that lens, we are going to see the object, right? We are going to see the object from this the eyepiece, and then the object will be looked from this objective eyepiece. We are going to have the crosshairs, and then we are going to look towards the object, right? So if you see, right, I want to show you some other things, right? So So this is your objective, this is your eyepiece, right? And this is your objective lens. From here, we are going to have the stereo diaphragm. Here, we are going to have the stereo diaphragm. And then here we are from this particular point, we will be looking, right? This is the center point of your lens, right? This is the center point of your lens. Irshad, there is no request. Irshad,
Yes, sir.
there is no request as of now. Yes, I will go ahead. I'll go ahead and tell them to join later because I will be getting disturbed in between. Okay, so tell them to join in the next class.
Yes.
Okay, so this is right. So this is your object lens. This is your eyepiece. So here we are going to have the stereo diaphragm, and from here we are going to look towards the object. So what we will be doing is here. From here, the eyepiece, from this eyepiece, we are going to look, and this is your objective lens. We are looking towards the object, and this is the center point of your telescope. This is your center point of the telescope. Now, what I was telling is, right? So here, this is the stereo diaphragm. This is your lens, right? And this is your stereo diaphragm, right? So this is your crosshair. This is upper stereo, right? This is and the stereo diaphragm essentially consists of one stereo hair. This is we call it as a stereo hair, right? This is a cross hair, right? And this is your stereo hair. So upper stereo hair and the lower stereo hair, right? And we are going to look the object from this particular stereo hairs, right? This is the center. This is upper stereo hair. This is the downward stereo hair. So here. Like these are the different patterns of the stereo diaphragm that we are going to have it. Okay, these are the different patterns. Again, upper, lower, upper, lower, upper, lower. So this is what the different types of forms of a stereo diaphragm that we are going to use in case of our normal stereo, right? These are we call it as a stereo hairs. Is it clear? What is stereo hairs? Is it clear what is stereo hair?
Yes, sir.
Others?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, where the stereo hairs will be? Yes, where the stereo hairs will be?
Object piece and eyepiece.
Okay. So then we will be seeing. What are the telescope using stereo are having of three kinds, right? One is the simple external focusing telescope, one is external focusing telescope, and one is internal focusing telescope. External, simple external focusing, and then internal focusing, right? Regarding this, the tachyometer is must essentially incorporate the following features is. Regarding it is telling about the constant. Okay, it is telling about the constant, right? The multiplying constant. Regarding this, you are going to understand in detail when you are going to deal with there is an expression for this. So we are going to get this after that particular expression. The multiplying constant should have the nominal value of 100, and the error contained in this value should not exceed 1 in 1000. So nominal, the multiplying constant that we are going to use, right? It is the value of 100, and the error should not exceed 1 in 100. The axial horizontal line should be exactly midway between the other two lines. Whatever the horizontal line of sight is there, right? This is your horizontal line of sight, right? And this is your upper stereo and the lower stereo. What it is saying is the axial horizontal line should be exactly midway between the two other lines. So this crosshair should be exactly, it should be in the midway of the two other lines. The telescope should be truly anaphylactic. Okay. And then the telescope should be powerful, having the magnification of 20 to 30 diameters, right? So whenever we are going to see an object, it should have the proper zooming. Magnification is nothing but the zooming. The zooming should be proper in case of your telescope. Whenever we are going to have this telescope, right, we should have the multiplying constant up to 100, and then the horizontal line of sight should be, this line of sight should be exactly midway between the crosshair. The telescope should be analectic, and then the telescope should be powerful, having the magnification of 20 to 30 diameters. So this is the proper magnification, that is a zooming of the telescope should be proper. Okay, the aperture of the objective should be 20, 35 to 45 mm in diameter, right? And then the for a small distances up to 100 meters, ordinary leveling staff may be used. Okay, the ordinary leveling staff may be used. For greater distances, a stearia rod may be used. Okay, the stearia rod may be used for the greater distances. For small distance, we can use the normal, right, normal level, right, and we can use the stearia rod, may be used for the greater distances. A stearia rod is usually of one piece, having 3 to 5 meters length, right? As we are going to have the stearia rod, it is usually we are going to have 3 to 5 meters length. Okay, and then the stearia rod graduated in, as you know, the least count, right? The least count of your level, right? It is stearia rod graduated in 5 mm. That is, the 5 mm is the least count for a smaller distances, while for the longer distances, right, the rod may be graduated in 1 centimeter. Okay, so this is your 1 centimeter, right? Graduated reading up to 1 centimeter, we can have the reading. Okay, so this is your normal level, right? This is your normal leveling rod, right? So this is what your stearia rod and the normal leveling rod, right? Now, the different types of systems of tachymetric measurement that we are going to have is, we are going to have the various systems of tachymetric survey may be classified as the stearia system, means regarding the crosshair, right? We are having the different types in this stearia. This is what your stearia is, right? We are having the different types in it. So what are those types? One is a fixed hair method and the movable hair method, or we call it as a substance method. Now, what is fixed hair and what is substance method, right? And what are the different tangential system that we are going to have, right? And the measurement by means of a special instrument, right? This we are going to see in your the next classes, right? As of now, you should know about, right? You should know about what is stearia, right? In for today's class, you should know what is stearia, and how your for B division students, what is theodolite, theodolite advantage, right? What we can do with the theodolite, that we should know, right? And we should know stearia, right? What is stearia, right? So we should know all these things. So this is what your stearia rod is exactly, right? So normal level and your stearia rod, right? So this is what your stearia rod is. This is your stearia normal, right? And this is your stearia rod. Okay, so here we can use this particular thing. Laser sensor is going to be attached to the stearia rod if you want to have the accurate measurement of the your levels. Okay, so this is regarding your stearia rod. Okay, so I hope that you have understood what is, normally we will be using our normal leveling itself, right? Normally we are going to use our normal level itself in order to have the measurement of the distance. Okay, measurement of the levels. Okay, anybody is having any kind of a doubt?
Sir.
Any
No,
doubt?
sir.
B division students, you want something again on your theodolite? Theodolite disadvantages, or theodolite think you need to have something if you want to know theodolite, because your basic on theodolite has not been taken, right? So if you want anything on theodolite, whatever is necessary as of now in order to read the have the tachyometry, I will be telling you, right? in detail, more in detail, we are going to discuss in our next session. Anybody want to have some questions? Right? Anybody? B division?
No, sir.
B division, B division. Especially B division.
No, sir.
Okay. So the speed is okay? B division? See, I'm not going with the too much high speed because I want to acclimatize you people first, because already A division are well acclimatized with the things, right? I want B division students, if you have any doubts, even A division students also, if you have any doubts, you can ask. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Good, sir.
Okay. Srishti? Srishti is there?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Any other students? Just I want to check how many students are there. Okay. Kajal, Kajal Pawar, you have any doubt? Kajal Pawar, you are from B division?
No, sir. A division.
A division. Okay. Rajesh Murugod, do you have any doubt? I will be asking randomly, and it is a cross check whether you are going to attend, you are attending the class or no. It is again a cross check also. Okay, Sanskriti Sambajuche, any doubts?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
Sheikh Ahmed, Sheikh Ahmed.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any doubt?
No, sir.
The things are clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are going to discuss regarding the further aspects of your tachyometer in the next class. If you have any doubt, you are free to ask, and you can contact me anytime if you are having any kind of a doubt. Okay. So we are going to discuss regarding the different types of stadia and different your regarding the extension, your stadia, different types of system of tachometric measurement in the next class, along with say tomorrow's class is going to be very, very important to you, because we are going to study what is the principle of a stadia method, that we are going to study in our next class. And this will be the basics in order to solve the problems, right? So here we are going to have some of the calculations again, right? So tomorrow's class will be important to you, so attend the classes regularly without having the gaps in between. So we are going to end the session over here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.